is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we have a massive WWE action figure unboxing for you guys. We're going to be unboxing this massive pile of WWE action figures and just kind of going through them. I know we've reviewed some of them, but I did want to go through and just, you know, unbox them. Some of them we haven't reviewed. We have some other figures in here and just kind of take a look at each and every one of them and, you know, just unbox them, see what they're about, collect all the stuff, and see what we got all together, you know, when they're all lined up loose here. So if you guys watch the buying every WWE figure from my Walmart, then definitely go check that video out. But if you guys did watch it, you guys know that we did pick up all of these figures here. I also added a few figures. I got a few legends in here, and I also got the Ultimate Edition Sergeant Slaughter. Now, I'm not going to be unboxing this. If you guys would like to see the full review of this figure, definitely go check it out on the channel. But one thing I did want to do is I wanted to open this up and see if we got the Chase variant on camera. So let's go ahead and see. I'm just going to peel this thing back and unbox it and see if we got the Chase variant, because I'm going to keep this one mock. I got the other one for loose. I got this one for mock, and let's go ahead and open it up and see if we got the Chase.
Ah, horseshit!
Well, Brad, we did not get the Chase. That's pretty unfortunate, but, you know, this guy's going to stay minty fresh. I'm going to keep him up there in the closet. I have a few of the Mr. T figure, and I wanted to go ahead and get this one as well, and I'll probably track down the rest of the SDCC exclusives one day, but the Sergeant Slaughter figure looks good. Again, if you guys want an in-depth review of this figure or any of these elites outside of the Legends, go check them out on the channel, man, but there's the Ultimate Edition Sergeant Slaughter. Didn't get the Chase figure.
Horseshit!
Unfortunate, but at least we have one of those mugs. But let's go ahead and dive in, man. Let's start off with, you guys want to start with elites, basics? I guess we can go ahead and start with one of the figures that I have not reviewed here on the channel. I'm dropping figures and getting pissed. All right, so the first figure we got, man, is going to be the Legend Scott Hall. The reason I got two of these, actually, is because my local Target had 11 of them. I posted up a photo of it. They had 11 of them in stock. And I was like, bro, first of all, that's ridiculous that there's 11 of them. And second of all, they marked them down. They had so many of them that they put them on clearance, and they were $10 a piece. So I figured, why not get two of them? I can use them for something. I can get more of these t-shirts over here, use them for fix-ups and customs and things of that nature. So great Wolfpack NWO shirt. Looks really, really good. I'm glad to have that. So Scott Hall's looking pretty good. I like this head sculpt. Ab crunch is not bad. He's got the two sweet hands. Wolfpack gear. He's got the red boots going on. Great headband on there. Pretty dope. And he has the WCW mic, which is pretty cool. So that's another Scott Hall for the collection, and he's on ball joints, so that's really cool. You got the Scott Hall trunks right there, Wolfpack on the butt. Pretty nice. I guess I can go ahead and get the second one out of the packaging. That way, you know, it's already gone and done, and then we can move on to Legends Eddie Guerrero, which I don't think I did a full review of, but I have shown this off multiple times on the channel. Here's the second one, headband kind of falling in the face there, but I'm gonna go ahead and get him out of the thing. And there's our second Scott Hall, looking pretty nice. I like it. Again, pretty nice Scott Hall. Head sculpt's a bit off, I think, sometimes. Like, it depends on, like, your paint apps, but let's dive into our Legends Eddie Guerrero over here. Very nice figure. I think it came in one of my favorite figures of last year, I think. I think it was in the top three of my favorite figures of the year last year, which it's kind of weird because it doesn't feel like it was that long ago that we got it. Like, we're almost at the end of 2021. I don't even remember, like, I feel like this figure came out this year, but it was, like, the end of last year. But with the pandemic and all that stuff, man, I mean, the years and days and months and everything kind of run all together there, but there is the beautiful Eddie Guerrero. You got the I'm Your Poppy t-shirt right there. Great attire on there. Great head sculpt. And I was going to keep this guy mock, and the only reason I'm unboxing him is because I noticed the other day his box had pretty significant damage from something. Like, he got bent really hard. And I was like,
ah, horseshit!
Yeah! So I figured go ahead and open him up, and there he is. He looks pretty daggum good. I like this figure a lot. Great elite figure. One of the better Legends figures, and it's definitely the best Eddie Guerrero to me. All right, let's switch it up a little bit. Let's go into some basics over here, and let's dive into this elite. Oh, yeah, I wish this was elite. We have a basic Jeff Hardy. And you guys know how I am about the basics. This guy's probably going to go straight into the crowd, to be honest with you. I thought this was a pretty cool basic just because of the hooded shirt right here. Like, it's pretty cool that they gave him, like, the hoodie. The only thing I hate is, like, how the head sculpt has, like, the baldness on the sides. Like, no fade or anything. We've seen this head sculpt multiple times besides that. But it was a pretty cool basic to include, like, the hoodie shirt for Jeff Hardy. And then he's got the taped hands. I remember him coming out like this, so it's pretty cool to see it in figure form. But you guys know how basics are. I mean, they're pretty god-awful. But there's our Jeff Hardy. 40 basic. Next up, guys, diving into more basics, let's get into the basic 118 Finn Balor. Basic 118 Finn Balor, not my favorite head sculpt. Honestly, think it's kind of garb. But, you know, we had to buy everything at Walmart. And, yeah, it's the skin tone painted head sculpt of the Elite 70 Balor, like the Demon Jack the Ripper Balor. And I love the gear. I really wish this was an Elite. But, yeah, the head sculpt's just not my favorite, man. Like, look at him. Yeah, not my favorite. Just, I think the eyebrow, if the eyebrows were repainted, maybe the hairline was repainted, it'd probably look a lot better. But at the same time, just not feeling it, man. The Finn Balor looks a bit off to me. So, there is our Finn Balor. We do have a couple Roman Reigns right here. Not the most exciting figures. Like, the head sculpts are kind of bunged. You got the Wreck Everyone and Leave and the SummerSlam. I don't know, man. Not my favorite figures for sure. They're just kind of plain Jane. More thickness to the crowd over here. So there's the first one. And yeah, it's just, it's such a, like, how do these sell? I mean, I guess if you want a Roman Reigns, but like with the internet now, man, I know people buy stuff at the store and it's like you go down the aisle and the kids just want to be like, yeah, buy me the Roman Reigns. But at the same time, bro, like, Jesus Christ. They like, you just go online and order a damn Elite off Amazon or something. And then here comes number two of the Romans. And here's Roman number two. Identical in every way. Wreck Everyone and Leave. They've used this head sculpt since Elite 51. It's just got some true effects on there. So that is a very, very old head sculpt. Moving on. We do have a battle pack. We have Drew McIntyre and Seth Rollins. Really excited to get another one of these head sculpts. But let's go ahead and crack them open here. I think this is my third of this battle pack, which is absurd. So we got McIntyre figure stand, Seth Rollins figure stand, Drew McIntyre figure, and Seth Rollins figure, which is a great head sculpt. I really like the Messiah head sculpt, and then you have this Drew with some open knee pads, which is cool, but I'll probably, I don't know. It's the same head sculpt, got the updated skin tone on there. Pretty cool jacket for this basic Seth Rollins, which isn't bad, but yeah, man, I mean, I use these for knee pads and head sculpts. That's literally all basics are good for in my collection, unless you're a crowd member. Moving forward, guys, we have another battle pack. John Morrison and Kofi Kingston. Pretty upset about this Kofi. I thought they were going to give us the, like, gummy worm rainbow looking hair, but they decided not to do that, and they gave us blonde hair instead. Very upsetting. All right, guys, so popping it out here, you have the John Morrison side plate, and then you have the Kofi Kingston side plate, which is pretty cool. I think one thing that would be cool, like, I think that the side plate gimmick is kind of eh, but what I think would be cool is if you've collected every single championship showdown pack and you had all of these, like the little coin side plate figure stands, and you put, like, your elites on them, I think that would be pretty cool. So I don't know. It's a pretty cool gimmick. It's just like putting them on the title. I mean, I don't know. Pretty, the more I think about it, the more inventful it was, and I kind of dig it now. So I just convinced myself that it was sick AF. We have John Morrison, which I think this head sculpt looks slightly better than the Elite 82. You guys can tell me what you think. I know it's the same head sculpt, but I think it looks a little bit better with paint apps. And then we have Kofi Kingston, which is a really sick figure. I like this head sculpt a lot, and he comes with white knee pads for future fix-ups. Really wish it was an Elite, but, you know, what are you gonna do, Brad? Just complain about it, I guess. So I think this is pretty solid as far as an overall battle pack. Again, the side plate gimmick is kind of sick AF. Again, the more I think about it, the more I really enjoy it and think it's badass. And I guess while we're here, guys, we might as well knock out our last battle pack. And it's going to be this AJ Styles Matt Riddle battle pack, which I really wasn't that excited for. However, I like Matt Riddle and I like AJ Styles, so that works. More side plate gimmicks. You got Riddle and you got phenomenal AJ Styles. I really like AJ Styles is sick AF, man. With that P1 blue logo, that's freaking gorgeous. And then the Matt Riddle one's kind of plain Jane. Outside of that, we do have the figures. And the Matt Riddle figure is pretty decent. You know, it's got the lighter brown hair color. It's literally his last Elite. Not the new Elite 88, but his last Elite with lighter brown color hair. And then the AJ Styles is the same head sculpt that we've gotten on, oh my God, ungodly amount of figures. And it's kind of in a, yeah, it's not the best gear, you know. It doesn't even have the P1 on the elbow pad kind of garb. But P1, yeah, we've seen this head sculpt before. Battle packs and basics, man, that really make me go insane with the re-releases and the repeated head sculpts and things like years ago. All right, time to unbox probably the worst basic in this video, and that is Silver Surfer Red. My God. So they took the second version of the Rey Mysterio head sculpt and just painted it silver, and then they took the first version of Rey Mysterio basics and painted them just completely silver. This figure is just, oh my God, man. It is just not a detailed figure whatsoever, man. This is one of the worst figures of the year, I think. I think a lot of people would agree with that, but yeah, man, it's just not good. It looks cheap. It's just, I don't know. I think I really want to use the head, and make like a silver mast attire or something, but I don't know what I'm gonna do with it. I don't know how to do, I don't know what I'm gonna come up with. Next up, guys, I think people inform me that this is the Chase, or I thought this was Apollo Crews. Introducing basic whatever the hell Apollo Crews Bailey variant. No, but seriously, I thought I was unboxing the Chase Apollo Crews. I really like this Bailey. You know, it's kind of got like the older women's articulation on it. The attire is really sick. It kind of reminds me of the Jacksonville Jaguars, but really like it. You know, same head sculpt as Elite 80 Bailey, but not a bad figure. But that makes like my, I feel like I'm collecting up on the Bailey figures, man. Anything's better than that Network Spotlight, though. Okay, this is the figure I thought we were unboxing. I think this is the Chase variant 121 Apollo Crews. Now, cracking him open, this is the head sculpt that everybody was clowning on. I don't see Apollo Crews. You guys can let me know what you think down in the comment section below. I don't see Apollo Crews, but I don't know. It's like the eyes are off or something, but you got the blue, black, and white attire. You got black knee pads on there. Not my favorite. It kind of looks like Kimbo Slice a little bit, but I don't know. I'll probably head swap it on surgery just for shishes and gigs. But now that we have all these figures, we're definitely going to dive into some surgery. Wait till you see the pile of figures we got amassing over here, and we still have like five more to get through. But here comes the Kane SummerSlam figure, the one wave where the wave is bun. To go buy every figure from Walmart. Here's the Kane figure, man. I saw somebody on Instagram repaint this head, and it looked fantastic. It looked really good. Maybe I can pull some magic like that, but I'm not feeling the head sculpt right here. The neck down is okay. It just has the garbage basic articulation, but the head sculpt is just, I don't know, man. It's missing. It's missing details. It just looks like a, you know what face it reminds me of? The SpongeBob Soiled It face. That is what this reminds me of. Soiled it, soiled it, soiled it. That's what this reminds me of. Let me know what you think. All right, guys, down to our last four figures, and at least they are elites and they are nice. It's kind of crazy because you have like the quality of Ultimate Editions and elites and stuff, and then you compare that to the quality of basic figures, and it's like, yeah, the basics may suck, but the elites are elite, you know what I'm saying? So I don't know, kind of a balancing act between the two price points and what you can get there. But let's go ahead and dive into this Rollins, and it kind of is insane, but this will make, I don't want to say for sure, I want to say this is my eighth of this figure. It's either my seventh or my eighth. I want to say it's my eighth. Yeah, I think it's my eighth. That's freaking insane. I don't know if that's the record for how many I have of one figure, but you guys know that I love the pink gear, and it's Seth Rollins, and you guys know the ever-growing Seth Rollins collection. I think we're at like, I don't know, 80 elites maybe, maybe 70 something. Unfortunately, this head sculpt has like a misprint. You guys can see he's like looking off to the side, and his chin looks a bit weird, or like his face does. Like, look at that. He's clearly like his eyes are not in place, so that sucks eggs. I'll just have to head swap it, but really wanted to put this head sculpt on a different figure, so now that sucks eggs. But this figure is beautiful, man. The Rey Mysterio Halloween Havoc inspired. Excellent. Just one of my favorite figures, man. This is very dope. The pink pops off nicely. You can't complain about it. All right, guys, diving into our last few, we have the Chase variant Elite 86 Triple H. I've actually noticed this figure shell forms. I don't know why, but it does. But we have the beautiful cloth DX shirt right here. Always quality, always nice. I'll never complain about a cloth good shirt, regardless of how it is. And we have our mic holding hands in here. Always precious to have. We have a water bottle accessory that I forgot this figure even came with. And then we have our Triple H figure, so no. And it's kind of loose on the back end. Like, if you go all the way back, it kind of shakes, but it doesn't have loose, like, it's not loosey-goosey. It's just, like, if you push it all the way back, it has, like, a, it's kind of unfortunate. However, you got the red and gold gear. Not my favorite. You know, I definitely prefer the purple and black, which I already have, but this is nice. You know, I have a massive Triple H collection as well, so this will fit really nicely in there, and I'm happy to add that one to the collection, but that is a nice one right there. And moving into our last two figures, guys, we have The Miz and Carmella. And I really like the Miz figure. I love the white gear. And the Carmella figure is sick AF. I'm really excited to have another one of these because I think her parts choices were incredible. And the figure feels really good in the hand. And it might even come in at in a top 10 spot for a figure of the year. Like, it might. Right now, it is borderline on there. So we'll have to see where she finishes up. But you know, a women's figure has to be damn good for me to include it in my top 10 of the year. Because, you know, they usually jip out on the women's figures. So they've finally improved the quality, and it's been very, very nice for me, at least. So there's Carmella. Really love this gear. I think it's great gear. Black and pink looks sick And then you have the long socks right there with the shoes. Really sick. I love this figure a lot. Wish it was double jointed arms, but Carmella's a really dope figure. And then the last figure that we have, guys, is going to be none other than the Miz. You got the glasses, you got the pointer fingers, the entrance. And then you have the cliche massive rubber entrance jacket coat that they always give the Miz. You can deny it all you want, Brad, but I have the receipts. Bam, 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 bam. I told you, Bradley. Can't F it up. You have a signature headband on there that it's not focusing on. And not to mention, this is basically just an upgrade of the Elite 37 Miz that pretty much looks damn near identical to this figure. And you can't deny it again because I have the receipts again. I mean, maybe a slightly better head sculpt, but overall and all, it's basically the exact same figure, which is cool with me. You know, it's update. You got the interchangeable. I wish I had double jointed arms, but you have the interchangeable hands. You got the updated head. And a lot of people missed out on that figure, I'm sure, if they got into collecting later. So there's our white gear Miz, and I like it a lot. So there you go. And here's our mountain of figures. Pretty nice stuff. I had a ton of fun unboxing these figures. I like to do the unboxing marathon. However, I do enjoy the reviews. Speaking of which, reviews of Elite Series 89 should be starting in the next couple days. I think mine's coming in tomorrow. And so the following day is when they should begin. And I'm also announcing that in the month of October, I will be uploading twice a day, doing my best to upload twice a day. One is a WWE action figure video, and one will be a horror action figure video. So stay on the lookout for that, guys. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you guys wanted to see the pile, there you go. Look at the massive pile of figures. And Charlie. Charlie go. But yes, there is the massive pile of garbage that I'm gonna have to clean up now, which I absolutely love. But that is gonna wrap up this video and unboxing marathon, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you guys missed Vindication, definitely go check that out. But I'm getting out of here, guys. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you, and don't cross the line like me when I bought $400 worth of figures from Walmart that I didn't even love all of them. You crossed the line!